My first journey as international student in India here in less than 10 minutes. Let's go. Peace.
Welcome to Is Monacast, the French boy.
Namaste everybody, welcome back to the channel. So French boy Is Monacast again. I hope you guys are doing well. In this video here, there is a subscriber who comment on my video. He sent me a message there. No, he don't comment, but he sent me a message on Instagram. He asked me to explain my first journey in India here because he planning to come to India next month for studying, but he don't know how the journey will be, how the first, you know, the first time in India, how things will be. So he asked me to explain my own story so that, you know, he can take an example of that. My story was tough. Yeah, was really tough because first of all, I'm from Ivory Coast, study in India under a scholarship called ICCR. Yeah, when I got the scholarship, they asked me, oh, you need to go to India at this date. No, you need to apply for your visa and, you know, give us a date to book your ticket. I give them a date and they book my ticket. So I have to come to India as, you know, foreign student, you know, international airport of Abidjan. And in my country, they speak French, you know. So like, when it comes to English, I wasn't that comfortable when it comes to English. So I have to come to India alone with no one. I'm telling you guys, no one. This journey was just alone, myself and me. Ismo Nakes and Ismo, that's it. So at Abidjan International Airport, the plane took off. It was, you know, at Abidjan was okay. Everything was still fine. We took off. We reached Chad. Everything was still, because Chad, you know, is still, you know, is still close to media, and also they speak French. No problem. We from Chad we reached Ethiopia, Addis Ababa. When we reached Ethiopia, Addis Ababa, you know, it was a bit different. You know, like the vibe is a bit different because, you know, you're coming from there and like in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, but still I was feeling, you know, in Africa, because you know at the end of the day we're all African. You know, I wasn't feeling that, you know, that, you know, the, you know, the feeling that you like, you know, oh, I'm dead here because there is no one. So no problem, I was still okay at Addis Ababa airport. When I reached in Ethiopia, my phone battery was dead. And the crazy thing I did is I don't even think about buying a charger, because my charger was a direct, like, you know, direct floating charger. It's not like a cable. I don't even think about buying charger at the Sababa airport. So, you know, I just wait for the plane and we took off. I don't even think like, oh, I'm supposed to call people. No, I'm here. I just, hey, that's the journey. Let's enjoy the journey. Up to Addis Ababa was still okay. So we took the plane there from Addis Ababa. We land in Mumbai at 7 a.m. Oh my God. At Mumbai, when I reach in Mumbai, I'm looking left, right, up and down, in front and back. I don't see no one looking like me. I say, whoa, this is where my journey ends. Because like, no one looking like me. I'm thinking like, wow. So how I'm going to manage this one here? How? I'm sitting there alone from 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. I was at Mumbai airport, you know. I just went to the shop, buy something to eat. And when I went to the shop there, the food is completely different. The taste of the food is different. And I'm checking, I was tasting like, oh my God. So actually, this is what I came into. So I will manage this one here for like, you know. Already in Mumbai, my mind was in was already okay there. I said, nah, I'm dead here. But you know, I said, let's continue because we already here. Let's do the journey. Mumbai, I went there instead of also going to a shop and buy charger. I didn't even do that. I exchanged my dollars in Mumbai airport, but I didn't do anything. I sit there, wait for the next plane. It was Mumbai and Hyderabad. When I reached in Hyderabad, it was at night. And also, when like you come into India and you don't know no one here, nothing, please have at least, if like you reach in India for the first time, go to a place and find a SIM card, something like that. so that you maybe you can download an application and, you know, start moving, like maybe Uber or Ola. Yeah, Ola is an application in India here where you can book a cab. So the thing is, I don't even do anything. So I reach in Hyderabad at 8 p.m. The office where I'm supposed to go was closed. I don't know no one. I have no phone, nothing. So I have to take a cab from Hyderabad airport there to go to the office. I don't even know the price. This guy puts the knife here when it comes to the price. Actually, at the from the airport to the office, I think it's 700, something like that, or 700-800. This guy took 1,500 from me. 1,500, I think the double price. When I reached to that place, the office is closed. And I asked this guy, can you please help me to find a hotel around here so that I can stay there, and tomorrow morning I'll come here and do whatever I wanna do. He said, okay, no problem. This guy just took the cab, turn around, there is a hotel at the back there, he just dropped me there. This guy said, no, I have to pay for service. I said, what service? What is service in India here? Because in my country, there's no such thing, service. He said, no, I have to pay for service. So, the money was there, so, you know, I gave him, I don't know, 300 plus the 1,500, so I pay 1,800 for this small trip. Okay, that's okay. I went to the hotel, I paid the hotel, I slept there, and you know, tomorrow morning I woke up. I thought that the university was in Hyderabad. You know, I was so dumb at the beginning. I don't even take time in my country there to check where exactly is the university. But the problem is the person who was working in my embassy there. He told me no. The university is in Hyderabad. So for me, I don't know. So you know, I have to follow. But I should have checked online. You know, now if like, you know, someone wants to travel, I will advise him to check online to check where the university is. Everything. So I thought that the university was in Hyderabad. So when I reached in Hyderabad, I finished my paperwork. I said, can you show me the university? I said, which university? No, the university is not here. The university is in Visakhapatnam here. I said, Visakhapatnam, where is it? I thought that is something like you have to take auto and go there. Meantime, you have to take a bus or plane again. This guy, instead of booking my ticket from Abidjan there to Visakhapatnam, the limit was Hyderabad. So I have to book a bus from Hyderabad now to Visakhapatnam. That's a 12-hour journey again. I managed this 12-hour journey myself without phone, with nothing. I managed that, reach in Visakhapatnam at 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock, when I reached in Visakhapatnam, I was tired. I was, my eyes was, it's like someone who's just smoked drug right now. I was completely tired. When I was waiting at the bus station, you know, to wait so that, like, you know, the daytime I will go to the university, two people just pop up in front of me and ask me for 500 rupees to put gas in their bike. I said, man, what? You have bike, you don't have money to put petrol. I'm right now tired, frustrated, everything, and you ask me for money. Like I was pissed. I was willing even to fight, but hey, we don't know anything, don't put yourself in trouble here. So I just look at them like that and go. So now it was daytime, it was, you know, 7. I said, hey, let me find the university earlier. When I reached when I came out of the bus station, I tried auto. I said, please, can you take me to this university, Andhra University? Those people from here to Andhra University, they telling me 150. 150 from this bus station to Andhra University. Something is 10 rupees or 15 rupees. They asked me for 150. I don't know. I thought that, like, you know, under university was so far, like that. I managed, and I said, okay, 100 rupees. You guys say, okay. He took me just few, I don't even know if like 5 minutes, only, but because when it's morning, there is no traffic. So 5 minutes, the guy reached there 5 minutes. I'm like, man, but hey, I don't even calculate because I just want to reach the office. When I reach the office is closed, so I have to wait. I was so tired. I put my towel down there in front of the office and I was sleeping there. And after, when I finished, you know, at around 11, the people came and they started doing the paperwork and like where they direct me where I'm supposed to go. So this journey was very, very, very tough. And there is a lot of things, including this journey, that I've mentioned here, because I don't want this video to be so long. But there is a lot of things, and I'm sure I will make another video and explain all the story of my journey that you guys don't know. But before you come to India here, please, the thing that you're supposed to know is where you are, where you are going, which university you'll be coming in, and do not be fooled by people back home there who have never traveled to India. Because this guy, he said, no, someone will come and pick you up at Hyderabad airport. No one came to pick me up. No one, literally no one. I landed, I look left, right, no one looking like me and to come to pick me up. So some people lie, say, no, hey, don't worry, we'll come, we'll send someone, we'll send a cab, blah, 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 to pick you. That's a lie. That's a big liar. So know where you're going. And always, like, you know, manage to have your phone in chat, so that like if you reach in India here, you can use like a place Wi-Fi or someone hotspot to download the app like Uber or Ola to go where you wanna go first. Because, you know, when you come like that, MTN, blah 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 blah, is not easy. Yeah, especially if you are, you know, if you are like us foreigners who come in to India for the first time, it's not that easy. So basically, that's, you know, a little bit of my journey. I don't explain all the deep part, but I'm sure I will make another video and explain one part that is very, very relevant for me and it's very, very funny. But I will explain that in the next video. Thank you to watch that video. I hope you guys learn something for my first journey in India here. If you planning to come to India, you know, take notice, know where you're going, and you know, try to have connection with people already in the city, maybe, you know, if you have their contact, so that they can help you for the first time. Yeah, or else you will be in you know, you'll be in trouble, confusion, and, you know, tough journey. Thank you, and see you guys in the next video. Have a great day. Peace out.
Welcome to Ismonakis, the French boy.